had great games. So you're saying they? What are you talking about? They were trying to throw the game away. Exactly. If you can play like this, come on, let's go ahead and speed this up. Turnover after turnover after turnover.
The yakety sacks.
This is the yakety sacks. It's like an episode of MTV Cribs when they walk up the stairs. Exactly.
This is not where the magic happens.
This is all bad. Now, here's the thing. If you could turn over the ball this much and still put up points.
This logic is great.
Then you belong in my top five.
Right,
because if they correct these things and put it together, they're already tops in the league in points. Defense is creating takeaways. This is going to be one of the better teams. And I know Kyle Shanahan, he will correct things sooner than later. So, San Francisco 49ers, I see you. Shout out to the Bay. All right, at number four, the Green Bay Packers.
Wow.
Now, the Green Bay Packers, like Kyle said, don't let these guys get good. Now, here's the thing. I could talk all I want, but you know what? Let's hear from the QB1 for the Packers. Aaron Rodgers, what's up?
I have to say, this is one of the cleanest games my jersey has ever looked. I took basically one shot. I hit the ground one time.
Look at that jersey. So clean and pristine. Listen, he wasn't sacked one time. He wasn't pressured one time. So you're telling me that this offensive line and this running game and receivers are getting open so well that Aaron Rodgers can sit back in that pocket and manipulate defenses with his legs and his arm? I'll tell you what, forget about not letting the Packers get hot. Don't let Aaron Rodgers get comfortable in the pocket.
Okay.
He will pick apart anybody. That means this team could be dangerous. All right, number three, the Dallas Cowboys.
Go on.
Now, here's the thing about the Dallas Cowboys. You know, there's people that talk about this team. They talk about the contract situations in the offseason. I learned something a long time ago. People with really big heads have really big brains, and they say some good things. Check out this clip right here.
Let me guess.
There's something else that's very terrifying, and it's also in the NFC, and it's Ezekiel Elliott on the Cowboys, also 3-0. The four of us sat here all summer, all August. I made enchilada jokes. What was he doing in Cabo? He's never going to show up. Is he gaining weight? No, guys, he's fourth in the league in rushing. He's really good. He had 125 yards casually. He had 111 the week before. I still feel like he's going to get going. He's going to lead the league in rushing again, and we don't talk about it because it's all Dak looks great and the defense is good. Just be very afraid of Zeke still peaking as we're going into 4 weeks.
What? He's going to lead the league in rushing? Yeah, that's from Kyle Brandt.
Yep.
And he knows what he's talking about. So let me get this right. The defense is playing well. Okay, that's good. The offense coordinator, Kellen Moore, he's more creative than ever. Okay, all right. Dak Prescott is playing himself into possibly a $35, $40 million contract. Amari Cooper, still one of the better receivers in the league. And Zeke is going to lead the league in rushing? The Dallas Cowboys are for real. That's why they're number three on the list. Number two,
we got
the Kansas City Chiefs.
Hey, here we go.
Now, here's the thing. Earlier, I showed a clip of the San Francisco 49ers and all the turnovers in fast motion. I'm going to do the same thing for the Kansas City Chiefs, but I'm going to show some big plays because these guys, they lead the league with 18 plays of 20 yards or more. Just check out these bombs. These are beautiful. He's making it look easy. Check how clean he is in a pocket. And even when there is pressure, he's throwing off his back leg. He got one leg up in the air.
I need an NC-17 when I watch these. Highlights.
I know. You're drooling over
They're
there,
amazing,
Shrakes.
Right?
Hey, Shrakes, yeah,
this is
wipe your mouth, okay?
No girls.
I know you want a cigarette after this, Shrakes, but just relax. It's our early morning show.
Why am I hearing Enya?
But here's the thing. All jokes aside, if you're paying attention to this offense, even without Tyreek Hill, even without a strong traditional running game, these guys are as dangerous as ever. So they have to land at number two on the list. But at number one.
What is that laugh?
Until they beat these guys.
Uh-huh.
You can't get the top spot. It's the New England Patriots. And here we go. It's the New England Patriots once again. And I could care less about everybody saying, well, Nate, look at who they're playing. I didn't make the schedule. I don't care who they're playing against. What I do care about is the only way that you can score on them is check out this right here. Listen, these guys are out there beating
Gunner,
up our team.
Gunner.
Hey, come on. Listen, you had one job.
It's his fault.
It is his fault. The ball bounces in the end zone. All right. That's a touchdown, right? Okay. Now, how about this? We put in
Come on, Stidham.
Stidham. Hardly what are you doing? We get a pick six right here. So you get a muff punt and a pick six. That's the only way that teams can score on the Patriots right now. Right. Offenses aren't doing squat. And speaking of that, here's the graphic right there. Patriots defense have given up zero touchdowns. Zero.
Is that a goose egg? I like that.
That's a goose egg. It's crazy, right, Kay?
They've given up about 100 yards to quarterbacks through 3 weeks of play. Devin McCourty has 3 interceptions. Yeah. They have 6 as a team. It's crazy.
Unbelievable. Kay said it best. The defense is playing at a high level. The offense is phenomenal. They're going to continue to do this until somebody stops them. So that right there is my 5. The Niners, Packers, Cowboys, Chiefs, and, of course, the Patriots.
Okay. Pick this thing apart.
I have so many bones to pick.
Well, pick your bones.
A team goes to the Super Bowl, and for the 3rd straight week, you have an undefeated team. Where are the Los Angeles Rams, who have single-handedly stopped every offense that has faced them?
They're right around 6. They fell out of my top. Because
they never were in your
top. Not even best in their own division.
Their wins haven't been as impressive, Shrakes. I'm hard on the Rams, all right? I was an apologist for them for 2 years. Can I be critical of them, Shrakes?
The Niners over the Rams?
Yeah, I like what the Niners are doing. Unexpected. It's the unexpected success of these guys.
Didn't you hear him if you...
To be honest, Shrakes,
you know what I'm saying? Shrakes,
you know why I didn't put the Rams in my top 5? Because I expect more out of the Rams.
That's right.
You know what? I expect 35 to 40 points out of the Rams.
Now it's personal, too. They're never going
to... I'll talk to you in the commercial break.
Nate's power rankings. You need to hit him up at Nate Burleson at GMFB. Are you getting beat from people? Are you getting people?
Yeah, of course. Yeah. Holla at me, Nate Burleson on Twitter.
Hey, you know cool goose egg graphic.
Thanks, bro.
Shout out to producers eating Cadbury's.
After this, I want to introduce you to this man, nickname Rambo. He could be the angriest runner in the NFL, guys.
Oh boy,
I didn't sleep last night.
Rambo knocked.
I mean, the hardest one we've ever had.
But I feel like now you're letting other people influence what you're doing and picking. I don't know about that.
Come on in.
Nelson Aguilar responding to a Philly hero. This went viral. You need everywhere. Hakeem Law is part of a group of really good Samaritans. They were helping firefighters rescue children out of a burning building on North 52nd Street in Philadelphia. And when Laws was interviewed by the local Philadelphia media, the news early in the morning, he not only described his heroics and the scene that was going down, but he also took a jab at a beloved Eagles receiver as well. Take a look.
By that time, the ladder truck was pulling up, and ironically, one of my old co-workers took the ladder off the truck, raised it up, and was assisting people down. My man just started throwing babies out the window. Wow. We was catching them, unlike Aguilar.
Nelson responded to the heroic fan, tweeting, "Thanks for being a hero in the community. Would like to invite you and your family to the next home game." Shregs, you brought this to our attention early yesterday morning.
This went viral yesterday morning, and the look at the camera is, he looks at,
like you know what I'm talking about.
Like, come on.
Right? Am I right?
It's so Philly, it hurts. This is it. The guy's saving babies from a burning building, and he's got a second to take a jab at Nelson Aguilar. Unbelievable. That's sports fandom. That's everything, right?
It's the context. Like, this isn't a story about long lines at the airport or they open up a new pool in town. Babies are being thrown out of a building, and he's getting in a wide receiver 3 joke about the Eagles. You can't beat it. It's so good. So good.
I love how Nelson responded, though. You know, it's like, all right, listen, I get it. The joke's on me. First, he responded by, I'll do better, but hey, if you want to come to a game, come kick it with me. I hope that they actually do a video together, because that would be the epic, full circle.
I heard Aguilar tried to call him, but the call dropped.
Oh, Aguilar didn't even have a terrible game. Yeah, there were a lot of mistakes, but it wasn't awful, and he's got a chance to rebound.
Yeah, they won a great run at the end.
Yes! It was a beautiful play, and they, of course, try to get their thing done at Lambeau this week. Thursday Night Football on NFL Network, the Eagles facing the Packers, just 2 nights from now. Will Salva's out in the newsroom in Culver City. We had a Monday nighter between the Redskins and the Bears. What's going on with Case Keenum?
All right, thank you, Kay. Well, the Redskins rank now 22nd in total offense in 2019. Keenum underperforming, to say the least, but then again, most QBs do when Khalil Mack is constantly invading your personal space. Now, Keenum had a career-high 5 turnovers, 3 picks, 2 fumbles lost. Up next, the Giants on the road with rookie Daniel Jones now under center. A reminder to head coach Jay Gruden that he has a rookie of his own on the sidelines named Dwayne Haskins. Gruden insisted, though, he's not giving up on Keenum yet.
The most important thing is we have to have some continuity. You know, I can't be changing people every 5 minutes here. So I think Case, I got to give Case another an ample opportunity to play with these new guys. I mean, this is his first time in this offense, really. You know, Donald Penn, Eric Flowers, their first time in this offense. You know, Terry, Trey Quinn only played 2 games last year. I made this point before. We're not going to be perfect, but we need to be better, and I think we can get better. Otherwise, if I didn't think we had a chance to get better, then I would make a change. But I feel like Case has the tools to become a very efficient quarterback in this offense and get us some victories here moving forward.
All right, so Gruden showing faith in Keenum. Meanwhile, the Ravens recently hosting their third annual Play 60 All-Ability Football Clinic with around 75 athletes from Special Olympics Maryland. The athletes going through football drills and activities under the instruction of Ravens players. The program designed to encourage individuals to be active for at least 60 minutes a day. Moving forward for the Colts, safety Malik Hooker could miss a few weeks after suffering a knee injury in the win over the Falcons. Head coach Frank Reich saying they haven't discussed putting Hooker on injured reserve at this point. Hooker yet to play a full 16-game season in his career. That was a sweet snag right there. And speaking of Reich, I'm looking forward to his visit to the show today. Frank Reich, Colts head coach, is going to be on the show, so we'll be able to ask him about Malik Hooker and other things as well. Still to come here on Good Morning Football, don't get this guy angry. You wouldn't like him when he's angry. That is Kyle Juszczyk. Is he going to be your angry run winner for week 3?